So bloating is a common digestive ailment that really causes major discomfort. It causes embarrassment. It causes emotional distress in many people's lives. And while there's many factors that contribute to bloating, one often overlooked root cause is histamine intolerance. Now, in a study of people with histamine intolerance, they actually found that an overwhelming majority, 92% of them, reported having either bloating or abdominal distension as their primary concern. Now, if you're someone who recently took an antibiotic for some kind of infection, or something happened to really just change your microbiome, and a few months later, you started experiencing GI symptoms like bloating, like the abdominal pain, and maybe other histamine intolerance symptoms, then I want you to realize that you are not alone. And if you're new to my channel, I'm Dr. Hagmeyer, and I'm a certified functional medicine practitioner. I work with patients all over the world who struggle with histamine intolerance and gut issues, as well as many other chronic health problems. And so in today's video, I want to share with you and help you gain just a better understanding of this connection between histamine intolerance and the microbiome, what's happening in the microbiome, and the symptoms that you're experiencing, like the bloating and the abdominal pain. You know, it's often said that histamine intolerance starts in the gut. And after today's video, I think you're gonna understand exactly why this is. So why does histamine intolerance and the microbiome, why does it leave you with bloating and abdominal pain or even stomach pain? Well, here's the deal, and here's what you need to know about histamine and bloating and the bacteria that make up this microbiome. Really, again, remember that your gut microbiome refers to really a collection of trillions of microorganisms, right? These are things like bacteria and yeast and viruses, and they inhabit the gastrointestinal tract, primarily in the intestines. Well, these microorganisms, they play a crucial role in so many different aspects of health and disease. The key to good health, though, in the gut lies in something called diversity. The greater the diversity, the bacterial diversity, the greater the gut health. Now, in the beginning of this video, I said that 92% of people who have histamine intolerance, they struggle with either bloating or abdominal distension as one of their primary GI problems. And if you're someone who was on an antibiotic or something else that would have negatively affected your microbiome or even damaged your gut mucosal lining, then one of three scenarios is really taking place in your gut right now and causing your histamine bloating and your histamine abdominal pain. All right, so scenario number one is you could have developed an overgrowth of histamine-producing bacteria. These bacteria include things like Klebsiella and Morganella, Prevotella, Staphylococcus, Proteus. Again, these bacteria produce histamine. Scenario number two is you may have very low or even low levels of histamine degrading bacteria. These are bacteria that break down histamine. Ruminococcus, Prevotella, and Faecalibacterium prausnitzii. These bacteria, again, they're helping to degrade histamine. And people who have histamine intolerance, they don't have enough of these on testing. All right, and finally, scenario number three is you have damage to the cells within the mucosal lining that actually produce DAO. Now, this can happen in people who have things like SIBO and non-celiac gluten sensitivity and inflammatory bowel disease. And I'll get into a few others that also damage this mucosal lining. But remember this, within our gut, we have three classes of gut bacteria. We have the bad bacteria, which again, most of us have heard of. These are things like H. pylori and E. coli and Salmonella and C. diff. We have commensal bacteria or keystone bacteria. These are the bacteria that we want to see in our gut. We expect to see them as part of our microbiome. These are considered the good bacteria. And lastly, we have opportunistic bacteria. Opportunistic bacteria are things like Klebsiella, Morganella, Pseudomonas, Staphylococcus, and Streptococcus. Again, these opportunistic bacteria, these are often found in the gut microbiome, but keep in mind that they're at such low levels that they don't really usually cause a problem. But under the right circumstance and when the right opportunity presents itself, these opportunistic bacteria can really wreak havoc on our health. Usually these bacteria, again, they don't get out of control and they don't cause problems. But there are a few scenarios that cause major shifts in our microbiome that set us up for this histamine intolerance and this bloating and this abdominal pain. Maybe you took antibiotics or you went on a sugar binge, or let's say you started taking birth control pills, or you consume alcohol on a regular basis. Maybe you had or sustained an injury to the mucosal lining because of food poisoning, or maybe eating gluten and dairy. Whatever the reason, the end result was that there was a drastic shift in your microbiome and it took a turn for the worse. Well, when this happens, these opportunistic bacteria, they begin to colonize and they begin to take over our gut. And in many patients with histamine intolerance, this is exactly what we see on their stool testing. And it's the reason why the bloating and the abdominal pain is there. Either you have too many histamine producing bacteria, or you don't have enough histamine degrading bacteria. So again, it's about that balance. Now again, on a stool test, those opportunistic bacteria like Klebsiella and Morganella and Pseudomonas, these again are just a few of the species that we see take over when given the chance. Now, as these bacteria, as they begin to colonize, they get stronger and stronger and stronger. They begin to make biofilms and they begin to crowd out good bacteria. And that's exactly what they're doing on this patient of mine whose test that you can see right here. Now, another thing that's important to realize, what do you do when you find out that this is happening? Well, here's a few things you need to do that will help improve bloating, help improve abdominal pain, probably improve the diarrhea, and probably improve many of your histamine intolerance symptoms. Number one, start out avoiding high histamine foods. Eliminate foods such as fermented products. This is going to be sauerkraut, soy sauce, aged cheeses, smoked meats, alcoholic beverages. In the short term, removing some of the foods that is really feeding these bacteria may help relieve many of these symptoms. Now, for a period of time, you may also need to stop eating really all forms of sugar, maybe need to stop all grains, all starchy carbs, and you may need to follow a low glycemic index diet. Here's where keeping a food diary can help in identifying and correlating how you feel with the different foods, right? So again, keep a chart of your symptoms and keep an intake of your food. Now, if you don't know how to start a low histamine diet, if you go to my website and download my ebook, you can download that for free. Okay, so number two is you need to start taking the enzyme diamine oxidase, DAO. Now, when this DAO enzyme doesn't work properly, maybe because you have a mutation in the gene, or maybe you have damage again to the mucosal lining and the cells that make DAO, you're going to get a buildup of this histamine. And this is why you need to supplement with DAO. DAO taken in a supplement form can help break down not only the ingested histamine from the foods you eat, but also from the high histamine producing bacteria in your gut. Now, if you want to know more about this DAO enzyme and the genetic mutations of DAO and HNMT, again, you can visit my website or you can go to the description box and I'll leave a link for both of these articles for you to read at a later time. Okay, so number three is you need to rebalance your microbiome with histamine-degrading bacteria. Remember what I said about the bacteria in the microbiome? You can either have too many histamine-producing bacteria on one hand or not enough histamine-degrading bacteria on the other. Both of these can be a problem. So again, rebalancing the gut microbiome is another significant step. Taking certain probiotics such as Lactobacillus rhamnosus, Bifidobacterium longum. This is again another thing that may help reduce your histamine levels. You should also consider taking the friendly yeast called Saccharomyces boulardii alongside these histamine degrading probiotics. And yes, you can take both kinds of probiotics at the same time. As a good and beneficial yeast, Saccharomyces boulardii has been shown to have histamine degrading properties, increase secretory IgA levels, breaks down candida biofilms, helps with the production of short chain fatty acids, and so much more. Now, if you're someone suffering with histamine intolerance, but you also have diarrhea, I want you to know that I did a video on Saccharomyces boulardii and why I recommend it. It's very helpful for people who are taking antibiotics and in the case where you have diarrhea alongside bloating. All right, so number four is you need to get rid of histamine producing opportunistic bacteria, right? If you have opportunistic histamine producing bacteria, like the ones that you see here, you need to work with a certified functional medicine doctor, someone who knows how to eliminate these bacteria. Studies have shown that Klebsiella, Morganella, Proteus species, not only do they produce biofilms, which makes treatment difficult, but again, they are high histamine producing bacteria. And number five, you have to treat SIBO. Now, SIBO is a colonization of bacteria in the small intestines. It can be due to too many good bacteria. Again, it can be too many bad bacteria. But the big thing here is bacteria don't belong in the small intestines. They belong in the large intestines. And if you have bloating, there's a good chance that you also, unfortunately, you have SIBO. Bloating by itself can keep your ileocecal valve open. And if this ileocecal valve stays open, Remember, bacteria can now migrate from the large intestines up and into the small intestines and cause SIBO. For the bloating, I recommend a couple things. I recommend that you watch the video that I did that explains the importance of the ileocecal valve when you have SIBO, as well as the ileocecal valve release technique. I also recommend that you watch my SIBO playlist on my YouTube channel. Now, if you suspect small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, SIBO is one of the things that can damage the mucosal lining and the cells that make DAO. And this again is why it is really usually necessary to treat SIBO alongside histamine intolerance. So you have to treat these together. It's also the reason that many people who try a low FODMAP diet never feel that much better. It's not that a low FODMAP diet didn't work. It works great if you're only dealing with SIBO. But here's the thing, most people have a lot more going on than just SIBO. Number six is reducing the environmental exposure to allergens, all right? This is really important because minimizing exposure to pollen, mold in your shower, mold in your home, and other environmental allergies can trigger histamine release. And this is also going to be super helpful identifying these things. Now, here's where using things like air purifiers, making sure that you are changing your house filters every few weeks, making sure that you're dusting surfaces, making sure that you're maintaining just a clean living environment to reduce these airborne allergens in your home. That can make, again, a big difference. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's video on histamine intolerance and bloating and the microbiome. I know we covered a lot of information. I know it can seem a bit overwhelming and daunting to try to pull all these pieces together, but if you need help trying to put these pieces together, you can always reach out to me by visiting my website, drhagmeyer.com. I hope you learned something new today, and if you did, drop me a comment below in the section that you'll see. And if you like today's video, here's another video that I think you're going to like as well. Till next time, take care.